And we have ignition. There we go. All right. And we're gonna drip. We're gonna drip. Oh, we're getting drips. All right, guys, today we're talking about FibreX Nylon plus GF30 from 3DXTech. This stuff right here. This is a 30% glass fiber reinforced nylon 6 copolymer, or PA6, which is polyamide 6, and it's an industrial grade beast. 3DXTech formulated this specifically to be very stiff and strong without being brittle. Now, polyamides, or nylons, PA, are the workhorse of the plastics industry because of their excellent mechanical, chemical, and thermal resistance. Now, this is the same type of PA6 used in the automotive industry for under-the-hood applications because it resists fuel, lubricants, heat, and mechanical loading up to 170 Celsius. FibreX PA6-GF30 is suitable for use on practically any open source 3D printer with a heated bed. That's right, you don't need a chamber, although it can help. So here's the box and the spool inside. When you buy it off our store, it looks just like this. You'll notice it's very, very thick, vacuum sealed bag. Now, if this comes to you and it's not vacuum sealed, don't worry. You're gonna have to dry this out of the box anyway, as with all the nylons and most materials in general. It does absorb some moisture, just like nylon 6, so you will have to do that. Just keep that in mind. So let's talk a little bit about where you're gonna see this stuff used in industries. Really, it's ideal for structural engineering grade applications. It's exceptionally stiff and strong without being brittle like a lot of the carbon fiber blends you'll see. It's got excellent chemical resistance. It's very suitable for numerous automotive and industrial applications in chemicals and solvents. It's got super high thermal properties, up to 170 Celsius for in-use applications, depending on, of course, the mechanical loads that are applied to it. And it's got improved dimensional stability over nylon because the glass fibers reduce the shrinkage, the lifting, the curling, the warp, and it has very, very, very strong layer bonding. By the way, if this information is helpful to you, please hit that like button. It tells the algorithm on YouTube that our content is valuable and you want some more of it. And you might as well subscribe while you're down there because we've got a ton of these videos and comparison videos still coming out on the way and content every week. So, what kind of machine do you need to actually print this? First of all, your nozzle temperature needs to reach at least 260 Celsius up to about 280 Celsius. And you can kind of go a little bit higher than that as well. As for the bed temperature, 60 to 75°C works for most applications, and with adhesive, with our nanopolymer adhesive, it actually works fantastic with this blend of nylon. Now, as far as a chamber goes, a heated chamber, it's not required, but it always makes nylon print a little bit better. Now, let's talk about some basic material specs. So, like regular nylon or carbon fiber PA6, it's got a glass transition temperature of around 70 Celsius, but the HDT, heat deflection temperature, is much higher thanks to the 30% of fibers, all the way up to 186 Celsius. Now, let's get into some basic strength specifications. For tensile strength, you're getting around 63 megapascals and a tensile modulus of about 4,261. But do keep in mind the way you print your part and the way it's designed and the orientation at which it's printed is going to have a dramatic effect on strength because of that Z-layer adhesion that's one of the things in FDM with almost every single material. So definitely print it in the best orientation and design your part for FDM first. Now, if you want all the other data, all the data sheets are online on our website at visionminer.com/data, so you can find all the tensile modulus, the elongation impact strength, and all that juicy good stuff on there. Next, let's talk about some electrical properties. Now, because this uses glass fiber instead of carbon fiber, it still carries the insulative properties of nylon for electrical applications. This particular blend has a surface resistance of 10 to the 9th ohms squared on the ASTM D257 testing standard. Now, let's just get into it real quick and test out some example parts. Let's check them out, and then we're gonna break them, we're gonna burn them, we're gonna do all that good stuff. The first thing you'll notice about PA6 with 30% glass is the surface finish is much rougher than most other materials. I mean, you can tell there's some fibers coming out of this thing. It's probably 2 or 3 times as rough as regular carbon fiber nylon. So the layer lines are extremely hidden, but the whole surface is very, very textured. Now, I'm just gonna show you real quick the difference. This is CFPEI, and as you can tell, this is CF Ultim, super high temp, really, really cool material. But as you can tell, the surface finish, I mean, you should be able to see that texture. It's significantly different. Now this stuff is around 10 to 13% carbon fill, whereas this is 30% glass fill. You really, really, really notice a difference. Now let's go ahead and take these things and burn them and break them. Now before I do that, safety first, kids. Safety third, I don't know, whatever. I'm gonna bring out my handy dandy Babco vise along with my safety glasses, of course, because this stuff might explode. Now, it's not supposed to be as brittle as the carbon fiber stuff, but we're gonna test that. We're gonna see exactly what happens. Before I do, we're gonna do the vase test. And I'm just going to take my thumbs and shove them into the vase, and we're gonna watch and see how it breaks, where it breaks, if it even breaks, see if PA6 didn't break. I actually crushed the entire vase, and it didn't even break at all. So we're just gonna start with that. I'm just gonna put some in here, see what deflection is like. All right, yeah, it's deforming. It's definitely soft. Now I see some layers splitting. It's a little bit different. You're gonna have a little bit different layer adhesion with all this fiber, I guess. Okay, put it in there and break it apart. Now as you can see here, it's breaking across the layers, but it's shifting up and down through the layers constantly. Let me do a full crush on this puppy. All right. Interesting. This stuff, it feels, I don't know, it's weird. It feels soft. It's definitely not brittle. They did a great job with that. We're getting stringing. I've never really seen that. I don't know if you can see that on camera, but all these little tiny strings, and it's almost like fiberglass, which technically it is. Before we get into the burning test, I'm actually gonna break this little sample bar, just like all our other comparison videos, and let's check it out. Ready? Here we go. Ooh, okay, so it broke. And as you can see in here, good layer fusion. You don't really see the layer lines and whatnot. I'm gonna break this apart. Yeah, it's definitely stuck to itself. All right, cool. Well, let's get into some fire stuff now. Before I do, to protect myself and others from the fumes of burning plastics, I've got the BOFA fume extractor. This is the Print Pro 2. Comes with this awesome little flexible arm here. And I love using this for soldering in the office, even grinding. It'll pull up some particles. And I'm just gonna turn this thing on. We got this on our website at visionminer.com/BOFA, along with the Print Pro 3 and 4. And they are enclosed systems. This one actually filters and just goes out into the air. But it's $600-700. Anyway, really, really handy device to have, especially if you're gonna be burning stuff in a studio, Rob. All right, I'm gonna light this on fire and we're gonna see how much it smokes after I put it out and what it drips like. And we have ignition. There we go. All right. And we're gonna drip. We're gonna drip. Oh, we're getting drips. I definitely used to do this with army men in the backyard. Sorry. I lit my neighbor's lawn on fire one time. Call me a pyro, will ya? Yeah, I love it. It's high temp. It's fire. It's good. That was cool. All right. Interesting. Now, instead of doing such a thin-walled part, let's actually light on fire this sample bar because it's a lot thicker. And so we'll sort of see how the letters react to, you know, when exposed to open flame. Let me just get this thing on fire again. Let's get back to the good stuff, Rob, right? okay. All right, we got full ignition on the side there. It's a little blue flame. You can barely see it. All right, now that's picking up a little bit. So hold it down like that. I'm gonna see how long it takes before it drips. It's about to drip. Dude, it's like boiling. This is freaky looking. This is not something you want to use when it's going to be exposed to direct flame. I'm just going to put this out. Because, oh yeah, nice and deformed. I like that. And the whole thing is soft. So, maybe not the best material for direct flame. We've got a bunch of other high temperature, high performance materials on our website like Peak, Ultim, PPSU that are flame retardant, will not catch on fire, will self-extinguish, and will barely off-gas at all. Thanks for watching this video. Check out all our different materials at visionminer.com/materials. You've heard that enough times already. And yeah, thanks for watching. Have a positive rest of your day, and I'll see you on the next video.